Hello everybody, my name is Nicola Tomatis and I am the CEO of the company BlueBotics. The market for vehicle producers is today moving fast. While most of the material handling is still manual, in reality today there is a clear trend that this will go towards automation. So on one side, still the market is more manual, but someone has to think about automating their vehicles for the future. Automatic guided vehicles started being used in the automotive for the production of cars and in pallet handling. Basically, until 20 years ago, these were the only two applications. While in the last 20 years, a lot has been growing and changing. First of all, logistics took a lot of space, and especially so logistics, but also e-commerce. And even other applications outside the automotive, they were gaining traction and they're still gaining traction, like production in electronics, but also plastic, metal, food. These are really applications that take more and more importance in the AGV market. Navigation solution to move around these kind of vehicles started in the 70s with the line following. This is about following a line on the floor, which can be an inductive wire, a painted line, or a magnetic tape. Then a big revolution came in the 90s, where triangulation was born. Triangulation is about having a laser on top that is measuring reflectors on the walls. The big difference between these two kind of technologies is that the first one was very simple and robust, but really heavy to put in place and to maintain. So triangulation brought a more little bit simpler installation, but especially a much easier maintenance. And finally, let's say between year 2000 and 2010, natural feature navigation came to the market. A natural feature which relies more on the environment and made it much easier to install and to maintain, and especially brought to the market much more flexibility in the use of AGVs. Natural feature navigation is about using structure feature in the environment in order to localize and know where the vehicle is. A supplier can provide to the market a very accurate and robust natural feature navigation, then this type of technology can be used for any kind of application. Of course, it's not so easy because the environment changes a lot, but again, providing accuracy and robustness allows to automate any kind of application. Yeah, obstacle avoidance is a big topic. So, first of all, obstacle avoidance is about moving around objects that are on the floor, because one has to know that the old automatic guided vehicles, they were moving on pretty fine paths and they were stopping in front of obstacles. So this is, by the way, the excuse that are being used by new suppliers to forge a new name, which is Autonomous Mobile Robots, AMRs, which is supposed indeed to be in contrast to AGVs, automatic guided vehicles. Now, the topic is very broad because there are applications where avoiding obstacles makes sense. Like if you have a cleaning machine that has to move everywhere, then you will find obstacles and it makes sense that you move around them. Or if you have a guide robot in an airport where it is very crowded, there it makes sense. Unfortunately, AMR suppliers, they try to sell this as the final solution, but it is not true. There are a lot of cases where it makes no sense. The first one is very simple. Most of the production lines and warehouses, they have no space to have machines moving around. So obstacle avoidance in this case makes no sense. Or when you are seeking a lot of efficiency, then it's difficult to use obstacle avoidance because you want to have very precise and timing in the delivery. And another example is if you have many vehicles around, then you need to have a very good traffic management in order to guarantee delivery. And traffic management is not really compatible with obstacle avoidance. So we have obstacle avoidance with our solution. It's an option that one can use, but we advise our customers not to use it for production and warehousing applications. For vehicle suppliers, when they automate their vehicles, if we have to define three key aspects that are important for success, I would say the first one is simple commissioning. in a kind of very simplistic way, one says automation is about 30% component cost and 70% integration cost. If a vehicle supplier wants to be competitive, you better reduce then the cost of the 70%. And this is also key to scale up the deployment of vehicles on the market. A second key point, it may look naive, but you better make sure that the technology is robust when in operation. Having a lot of newcomers bringing new technologies to the market is good on one side because it brings innovation, but you have to make sure that this is a mature solution and do the job when in operation. Finally, choosing technology supplier means that you will probably stay with this supplier for a certain time. So it's a big investment, so you better make sure that their support is good when you need it.